Thank you, Lord God. Praise you, Lord God. Bless your holy name, O God. We worship you. We adore you, O God. Hallelujah. We call upon the name that's above every name, the name of Jesus Christ. Lord, we thank you right now for moving on this Facebook Live, God. Touch your people now, God. I thank you, God, that you would bring a word of conviction, O God, that we would reverence your holy name and honor you, God, in all we say and do. For you alone are worthy, O God. Hallelujah, Jesus. Thank you, God. Hallelujah. Glory to your name, God. Glory to your name, God. Glory to your name. Hallelujah, Jesus. Glory to your name. Let the words of our mouth and the meditation of our hearts, O God, be acceptable in thy sight. You are strength, God. You are peace, God. You are hope, God. We call upon you, God. Hallelujah. For you are a bridge over troubled waters. You are a strong tower that we run into and find safety, Lord God. Help us, O God. Glory to God. Cling to you like never before. Lord, we lay aside every sin and every weight that does so easily beset us, O God. Father, I thank you right now for purifying our hearts by your precious blood. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Lord God, we come against every assignment, every plan, every attack of the enemy right now, God. Lord, have your way, God. God bless you, my brother. Glory to God. Apostles to God, we praise God for you, man of God. Keep doing what you're doing, my brother. Love you, man. Glory to God. Hallelujah, Jesus. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Praise you, Lord God. We bless you, Lord God. Let the fire of your Holy Spirit, God, move up on this Facebook Live right now. Father, hide us behind the cross that you will be glorified. Let no man see us, God, but see you, Lord God. I thank you right now for your peace, God, for your love, God. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus, we thank you for turning things around, God. In the mighty name of Jesus, as we look to the hills from whence cometh our help coming from you, O God, who is the maker of heaven and earth, O God. For you are the author and the finish of our faith, O God, and we just cling to you like never before, God. We trust you, God, and we lay aside every sin and every weight, God, that does so easily beset us, O God. Lord, we hunger for you. We thirst for you, God, after righteousness, O God. Feed us from your table today, God. In the mighty name of Jesus, God, we thank you for manna from heaven, O God. I thank you, God. Hallelujah, God. That we should never be the same, God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. A heart after your own heart, God. Hallelujah. To seek your face, God. Hallelujah. Greater passion, hunger, and thirst for you, O God. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus, God. Hallelujah. I thank you for divine impartation. I thank you for revelation knowledge. I thank you, God, for divine enlightenment, that we will never, God, walk in darkness, oh God. Hallelujah. That we will know the truth, and the truth shall set us free, God. Hallelujah. We come against every yoke of the enemy in the mighty name of Jesus. Bless you. Amen. Pastor Matthews, God, we thank God for you. Hallelujah. Praise God. Glory to God. We thank you, God, for the fire of your Holy Spirit moving right now, God, upon this nation, upon this world, God. Hallelujah. We pray for our president, oh God. Hallelujah. Your chosen president that you put in position. We hold him up, God, in the mighty name of Jesus. Glory to God. Hallelujah, God. We bless your holy name, God, for you're faithful, God. Hallelujah. Come on, just worship him. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. We trust you, God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to God. In spite of what things look like, God, we trust you, God. We stand on your word, for all your promises are yea and amen, God. Hallelujah. We are fully persuaded that nothing shall be able to separate us from the love of God, which is in you, Christ Jesus, our Lord. Have your way right now. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Praise you, O God. Amen. I bring you greetings in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. Glory to God. Hallelujah. We praise God for you. This is Bishop Campbell, yours truly. Amen. Of Global Life Changing Ministries International. Just want to come and share a word, amen, that God is pressing on my heart, amen. So many times, saints of God, we forget the times that we are in. Glory to God. Now is not the time to play church. Now is the time is to get in the face of God and walk upright, amen, to lay aside anything that's been holding you in bondage, amen. One thing the devil can't do, even God himself would not do, go against your will. Praise God. If you have a will to be saved, a mind to be saved, God will deliver you. Praise God. Amen. He's faithful like that. He's a loving Father. Praise God. I want to look at the Word of God. Amen. Coming from Matthew. Amen. The 24th chapter, beginning at the 3rd verse. Amen. It said, now as he sat on the Mount of Olives, the disciples came near him privately, saying, tell us, when will these things be? And what will be the sign of your coming and of the end of the age? They wanted to know, when was the Lord coming? When was he returning? Praise God. Saints of God, if I tell you this, we are in the time of the coming of the Lord. We are the generation that shall see the coming of the Lord. And it's time for us as church folk to get our house in order. Glory to God. Just because you may know about God don't mean you know him. Glory to God. When you know him, you have a personal, intimate relationship with God. And God has been pulling at our hearts, saints of God, to come closer. Glory to God in prayer and studying the word of God. Sanctification, amen, goes through three phases. The first phase is positional, where we confess and we believe in our hearts. Then we begin to utilize, amen, the word of God, which is progressive sanctification. And that means we go through the process of sanctifying ourselves with the word of God and by the Spirit of God and being washed in the blood of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Then what is called the complete sanctification was at the point of rapture, or when we at the point of death, when we are joined with our complete glorified body, saints of God. Hear me. Apostle Paul said, to live is Christ and to die is gain, and to be absent from this body is to be present with the Lord. So he said that if we die as believers, we're going to go into the presence of God, saints of God. Hear me. Now is the time more than ever for us to preach truth. We have to stop being men pleasers and worrying about if somebody don't like us. We got to say what thus saith the Lord. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Sometimes God will have you say things that's not popular. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Listen, it's not about popularity. It's about purity. We want to walk in holiness, saints of God. Hallelujah. We have to stand before God and draw close to God like never before, because if we're not rooted and grounded, we're going to be shaken. Glory to God. Us as the people of God, we are to keep our eyes on God, not on the things of the world. Glory to God, because we're in the world, but we're not of the world. And that's why Apostle Paul says in Romans 12:2, and be not conformed to the things of this world, but be ye transformed. The word transformation goes to the Greek word, which is metamorpho, where we get the word metamorphosis, which is mean a complete change, like a caterpillar becoming a butterfly. When we become who God has called us to be, saints of God, people won't even recognize you. Glory to God. And understand this. When God has forgiven you, whenever somebody bring up your past, it's no longer your past. It's theirs. Glory to God. Why? Because God throws our sins in the sea of forgetfulness. Amen. And he puts up a sign and said, no fishing. Glory to God. So when God is forgiving us, amen, we must go forth in the grace and the liberty, amen, where God has set us free to do what God has called us to do. Glory to God. Whenever, amen, when sin has us bound, we are limited. We cannot be effective, and we will not be reach our full potential by us half-stepping in God. Glory to God. God is looking for somebody to say, Lord, here am I, use me. Not, hear me, not concerned about a title, not concerned about a position. It's concerned about your heart. So many times, get this, we have people that caught up, I'm apostle this, I'm bishop this, I'm prophet this, get this, saints of God, hear me, and want to be magnified in the eyes of men, want to be praised by men. But get this, God has not set their a seal of approval on them. Glory to God. Because the Bible said that you should know a tree by its fruits. Amen. We should bear fruits. Amen. To show people that we're of God. Hallelujah. We have to have the witness of the Holy Spirit. Glory to God. It goes on and says this for the verse. And Jesus answered and said to them, take heed that no man deceive you. Everyone hear me. The first thing Jesus says, watch out for deception. In other words, hear me, how can you not be deceived? You got to know the truth. That means the word of God, to study, to show yourself
approved unto God, a workman that needed not to be ashamed, rightly dividing the word of truth. In order to rightly divide the word of truth, we have to have the Spirit of the living God on the inside. Amen. We got to have a teacher, amen, that's full of the Spirit of God, able to minister word, to preach to our hearing, amen, so we can have faith. And then, get this, even after that word comes across the pulpit, you still must take time to study, to examine that word to make sure it's God. Amen. It must bear witness with your spirit. Hear me, if you got the Holy Ghost, it's going to bear witness with your spirit when it's of God. When it's not of God, it's not going to bear witness. It's going to disrupt or disturb you. Glory to God. You're not going to have peace about it. Glory to God. But sometimes, everyone hear me, so many times we allow what we think we know about God to stop us from growing in God. Oh, glory to God. God is much bigger than what we can ever imagine. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. Something how when Jesus came and the Pharisees was criticizing certain things that he did, this and that. Get this. You can know the letter, but not know the spirit. Glory to God. And what's sad is people can study the word and miss the spirit when the spirit moved. Because get this, the spirit of God brings revelation. He brings insight. Glory. He brings depth and validity and shape. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Glory. We need the spirit of God, hear me, to carry us places where we will never go. Hallelujah. In the word of God. Fifth verse goes and says, for many will come in my name saying, I am the Christ, and will deceive many. And you will hear of wars and rumors of wars. See that you are not troubled, for all these things must come to pass, but the end is not yet. Everyone hear me. So many people in this world right now are troubled by what they hear and what they see around them. Hear me. But when you are walking with God, he will give you peace. A peace that surpasses all understanding. Glory to God. Hallelujah. David said it like this in Psalms 23. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will not fear no evil, for thou art with me. Get this. Sometimes God will have you going in dark places, but get this, to bring light. Hallelujah. You won't be afraid of the darkness because you got the light of God on the inside of you. Hallelujah. Glory to God. And sometimes, everyone hear me, sometimes God will have you in a cocoon where everybody don't understand what's going on. They wondering, they looking at you, they laughing at you, they talking about you, but you in the secret place. The Bible said in David, Psalms 91, he that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. Get this. You can get to the place where people think you crazy. Hear me. God ain't crazy, but people will call you crazy for your relationship with God. Hallelujah. When you get serious about God, God will get serious about you. Hallelujah. Glory to God. And understand me, God is never a plaything. But if you want to experience the greater good of God, obey God. Hallelujah. But hear me, I'm not serving God for what he can give me. I'm serving God because I love him. Glory to God. Because he's already done so much for me that I just can't tell it all. And what's so good about it? God ain't through with me yet. Tell your neighbor, God ain't through with me yet. You got to hold on and believe that God is about to do something great for you, saints of God. Hear me. He said, don't be deceived. He said, when you hear people saying that Christ is here, Christ is there, don't go there. Glory to God. Why? Because many false Christs shall arise, get this, to try to deceive even the very elect of God, but they can't deceive the chosen of God. Why? Because we know the Spirit of God. Hallelujah. And that's why, saints of God, God wants a personal, intimate relationship with us. And people got to stop making this as an excuse, saying, God knows me, God knows my heart. Yes, he knows how wicked all of us are. Glory to God. And so we have to be washed in his blood to be made new. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Let me go ahead and say this. 7th verse says, for nation shall rise against nation and kingdom against kingdom, and there will be famines, pestilence, and earthquakes in various places. All these are the beginning of sorrows. Everyone hear me. These very things are happening right now. Pestilence, diseases, famines are going to earthquakes, and all these things are taking place right now. Glory to God. And I don't understand. Get this. We see all these things around us, but we still ignoring the voice of God because we choose and we insist on our own way. Glory to God. We rather come to church and play games and front like we got God, but we leaving without him. Glory to God. Hallelujah. That's a good place for somebody to say, Lord, forgive me. Lord, help me right there. Glory to God. Because, hear me, what's the use of going to church if you're not going to change? Glory to God. I want to be better than I've ever been. When I go to church, hear me, even as a pastor, I go, hear me, to encounter God in such a way, saints of God, that I want to be made better. Hallelujah. Glory to God. So it takes dedication. It takes time of fasting, time of praying. We don't pray like we used to. We don't fast like we used to fast. Fast is ancient. Fast is not even heard of no more. Why? Because get this. Only time we fast is when we want a house, we want a car, we want a raise, we want a job. But when was the last time you fast to be holy? When was the last time you fast for deliverance? When was the last time you fast for breakthrough, glory to God, in your life? When was the last time you fast just to get closer to God? Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. I want God. Hallelujah. Because if I get him, I got everything I need. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. Glory to God. We're going to jump all the way to the 32nd verse. It said, now learn this parable from the fig tree. When its branch, let's go back. I tell you what, let's go back to the ninth verse. It said, then they will deliver you up to tribulation and kill you, and you will be hated by all nations for my name's sake. Everyone hear me. Let me give you this point real quick. Between the 8th and the 9th verses, hear me, something happened. And let me tell you what happened. It's called the rapture. Glory to God. And some people don't believe in a pre-tribulation rapture, but let me give you what the word of God says. Revelation 3:10 says this, because you have kept my command to persevere, I will keep you from the hour of trial which come upon the earth, which will come upon the whole world to test all those who dwell upon the earth. What are you saying? When God, he's going to rapture, means to be caught up, to take out. He did it in scripture, even with Sodom and Gomorrah, when he took Lot and his family out. Glory to God. And he told the wife not to look back, but she looked back and she turned to the pillar of salt. Get this. When God give us instruction and a word of command, we need to obey what God is saying. Hear me, saints of God. Partial obedience is still rebellion. Partial obedience is still disobedience. God wants our total attention. He wants us, get this, to totally surrender to him. I realize this. I can't live right without the Spirit of God. And so many times we trying to do it on our own, but everyone hear me. God wants us to surrender to his Spirit and let his Spirit live through us. Glory to God. Hallelujah. He wants the Spirit of God, him who is God. Glory to God. Hallelujah. To live on the inside. And that's why the Bible said, greater is he that is in us than he that is in the world. That means no matter what you're going through, when you got God on the inside, tell your neighbor, you got more than a conqueror. Glory to God. Hallelujah. The one who created the heavens and the earth. Glory to God. Alpha and Omega, beginning and the end. Glory to God. And that's why, hear me, when you cannot even believe in yourself, God still believes in you. Why? Because he knows what he put in you. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hear me. What is it saying? The righteous mean the one that obeyed God and kept God's word. Glory to God. Just because your name is on the church roll don't mean that your name is in heaven's book of life, the Lamb's book of life. That means your name may not even be on the roll of God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Church association, get this, don't put you in heaven. It's your personal relationship with God. Get this. And you walking in obedience. Glory to God. Fulfilling the call of God on our lives. And the word of God says this, saints of God. It says this. It says, in that day, he's going to say, depart from me, you workers of iniquity. I never knew you. But to the righteous, he's going to say, well done, thou good and faithful servant, for thou hast been faithful over a few things. Listen, may I not have been faithful over everything, but I've been faithful over a few. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. And that's what matters. Everyone hear me. Not according to my standard, but according to God's standard. Hallelujah. Because what has happened, we try to bring God down on our terms instead of going up on God's terms. Glory to God. God don't make no changes for nobody. He's God by himself. Everyone hear me. He's self-sustaining. He's self-sufficient. He's self-existent. Means nothing you do for God, get this, it can't make or break God. He's still God. Glory to God. Hear me. And our worship and praise to God don't make God better. Hear me, it benefits us because he's still God. Glory to God. Hear me, when we praise and worship God, it benefits us. It brings deliverance. It brings healing. It brings restoration. Glory to God. And that's why, get this, when Job lost everything he had, the Bible said he fell down in worship. Why? Because he realized that the Lord give it and the Lord take it away. Blessed be the name of the Lord, that all things, get this, happen according to God's will. Glory to God. He's the one that let and will let the sovereignty of God. Hear me. God can stop anything at any time. But there's some things, get this, God has to allow to happen, get this, to shake us up so we can come into the reality of who God really is. Glory to God. Hallelujah. You crying over this because you ain't got that. Get this. You crying over and wondering how God gonna make a way. Get this. Instead of praising God. Hear me. I dare you to praise God for something that you haven't even gotten yet. Glory to God. See, when you praise God in advance, get this, it inspires God to do something special for you. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Because when the praises go up, the blessings come down. For God inhabit the praises of Israel, the praises of his people. Glory to God. When you praise God, hear me, praise gonna cost you something. People gonna laugh at you, call you crazy. Why are they doing all this? Get this. But they don't know what you're in need of. Glory to God. They don't know that the time that you was about to lose your mind, the time you was about to quit. Hear me, even us as leaders go through times and moments where we try to get depressed. Why? Because sometimes we feel like we're all by ourselves. Glory to God. And there's nobody to talk to. Glory to God, but God. Hallelujah. And after, glory to God, we get through crying and pouring out our hearts to God. God said, get up, now dry your face and get before the people. Glory to God. Hallelujah. He always has a way of encouraging us. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Because sometimes, get this, you're not going to get validated by man. Sometimes man going to misunderstand you. But I thank God I serve the one that knows me inside and out. He knows my faults. He knows my failures. He knows my weaknesses. Glory to God. But get this, in our weakness, his strength is perfected in us. Glory to God. When we lean and depend, hear me, never allow your issue to become your identity. Glory to God. Hallelujah. It's time for us to put our issues on the altar. It's time for us to put ourselves on the altar. We got to go back to the heart of worship where, get this, hear me, it's not about being seen or having a great church or having a great ministry. We want to make sure that God is pleased, things of God. Hallelujah. Not how many members you got, not how much money you got in your bank account. When was the last time you ministered to someone that was less fortunate than you? When was the last time you just gave a kind word of compassion? When was the last time you went out of your way to do something, hear me, to make God smile? Glory to God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Everyone hear me. Some things God don't want to have to tell us to do. Some things God wants us to desire to do. That means to be good natured, to do something for someone. Glory to God. I always look to be a blessing. I had somebody talk to me today. They said, man, they said, you seem to be a good person, this and that. I said, I live to serve. Hallelujah. And he said, you're doing such a good thing to be able to do this for this people. I said, I've learned to let my giving be my receiving. I act just as happy as giving it as if I'm the one that's receiving it. Hear me, saints of God. God loves us so much. In this world right now, it's in bad shape. And everyone hear me. It's not going to get any better. Glory to God. And that's why we need to get our house in order. Glory to God. Stop going to church and putting off this and that. Why put off what you could do today for tomorrow? Glory to God. Now's the time. Now's the hour. Now's the day of repentance. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let's go to Matthew, the 24th chapter, 32nd verse. It said, now learn the parable of the fig tree. When its branch has already become tender and puts forth leaves, you know that summer is near. So you also know, get this, when you see all these things, know that it is near. Talking about the end. At the doors, assuredly, I say unto you, this generation will by no means pass away till all these things take place. Everyone hear me. We are that generation. We are the generation that God has put here to see. This is the time when the apostles wanted to be alive. And God, hear me, has chosen you to be a part of this generation. But whose side are you on? Glory to God. Choose this day whom you're going to serve. Glory to God. If Baal be God, serve him. If God be God, serve him. But get this. I serve God, the God that answers by fire. But he don't only answer by fire. He is a consuming fire. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to God. And then let me give you a little help. You know, when Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego was in the midst of the burning fiery furnace, get this, and King Nebuchadnezzar called him out of the burning fiery furnace, get this, how did he know when to call him out? Get this, because he saw God in him. He saw God, he saw the Son of God. He said the form of the fourth looked like the Son of God, and he called him out. Get this, even the mystery of a goldsmith, if he leaves gold in the fire too long, it's destroyed. If he takes it out too soon, he's going to put it back in. The way the goldsmith knows when to take the gold out, get this, is when he can see his reflection. Everyone hear me. When God can see himself through you, that's when he'll take you out of the fire. Glory to God. Many of us going through things, but we're going around in circles because we haven't learned the lesson. Glory to God. And God is trying to get us to learn the lesson. How do you learn the lesson? Because you learn what you did to mess up. Glory to God. So you learn not to do that so you can learn to progress. Glory to God. Because you have people that's going to church that's professing but not progressing. Glory to God. They just saying things with words, but they have no power. Glory to God. Why? Because their hearts are from God. And this day, saints of God, there has that we have a heart issue because we put everything we want in the way before God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. And now we have to come back to God. Isn't it something how God will allow you to keep on asking for something and God will give it to you to show you that you don't even need it? Glory to God. And then you crying and all messed up saying, God, I'm sorry, this and that. You kept asking for it. Glory to God. Sometime I realized this, saints of God, that the greatest blessings of God are when God sometime tell you no. Glory to God. Because he knows what's best for you. Glory to God. A woman can keep on desiring a man. No, the man ain't good for her. Keep on desiring them. When she get the man dogger. Then she just broken in all kind of pieces. Why? Because she looking on the outer appearance, but she didn't really know his heart. He was telling her everything she wanted to hear to make her feel loved. Listen, everyone hear me. Men and women, you can never fully appreciate a companion until you have first fallen in love with God. Because when you fall in love with God, you learn to love yourself. And by you learning to love yourself, you're able to appreciate someone else. And that other person, when they come, they won't make or break you, but they will help you be who God has called you to be. And you can help them be who God has called them to be. Y'all will enhance each other's lives. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Praise God. We're going to say this. Verse 35. Heaven and earth shall pass away, but my words will by no means pass away. That means his words are forever settled because he is God. God can't lie. Glory to God. God's word is true. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Whenever God makes you a promise, God will always see the promise to pass. Everyone hear me. Now, there's times when God will give us saying that there's terms and conditions. If you do this, then this will happen. But if you don't, this will what? Happen. Glory to God. So I choose to be blessed. I choose to accept what God has for me. Glory to God. Going to the 36th verse, it said, but of that day and hour, no one knows. No one knows. Get this. Not even the angels of heaven, but my Father only. Even Jesus, the Son of God, don't even know. But get this. Jesus and his armies of heaven have to stay on alert, have to stay ready. At a moment's notice, when God said, go, faster than lightning, faster than right now, before you can blink and bat your eye, it had already happened. Glory to God. The Bible said two would be in the field, one would be taking the other left. Glory to God. Two would be in the middle, one would be taking another would be left. Glory to God. I don't want to be left behind. I want to be ready. Glory to God. It's just like when you know somebody's coming over, special guest coming over to your house. Glory to God. You want to make sure that the house is clean, the house is prepared. Glory to God. You don't want somebody just coming at clothes thrown everywhere, dishes all in the sink, house is just filthy when you know they're coming. Why? because you want to leave a lasting impression on them. Glory to God. But you got people, some people just don't care. Glory to God. But when you're really concerned about a person and their, get this, their opinion matter. Glory to God. Hallelujah. You want to give them the best impression possible. Amen. Everyone hear me? So get this. I'm cleaning out my house, my heart today, because I want him to have first place in my heart. I don't want him to come and try to dwell in it, because he won't dwell in an unclean temple, saints of God. We are the temple of the Holy Ghost. The Bible said, if any man defile the temple of God, he will God destroy. Glory to God. And we have put so many things, because so many times we say, it's okay to do this. God had already, Jesus had already paid for everything that you ever going to do. Everyone hear me. The Bible said, shall we continue in sin that grace may abound? God forbid. Glory to God. Because when we do that, we're crucifying Christ afresh. We make it as if his crucifixion was no big deal, when real. Glory to God. Hallelujah. And if we defile this temple, everyone hear me. God will destroy. Why? Because we don't belong to ourselves. We've been bought with a price. Glory to God. God has given every man an opportunity to choose him. Get this. Just like Adam and Eve chose to eat from the tree of knowledge and good and evil, we must choose Jesus Christ as our Lord and Savior to be born again. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. And now's the time, saints of God. Things are happening. This coronavirus and all these different things. God could stop it at any time. But hear me, there's some things that just have to happen to wake us up and to shake us up. Glory to God. Because we had gotten to the place where we're trying to function and live without God in our everyday lives. Glory to God. But I don't know about y'all. I need God every moment, every second, every minute, every hour, every day of my life. Glory to God. Hallelujah. He's precious to me. Amen. He's dear to me. Glory to God. See, everyone hear me. When you haven't invested nothing, it doesn't cost you nothing. Glory to God. Hallelujah. But when you have dedicated your whole life, glory to God, you have all to lose. Glory to God. And everyone hear me. Why not choose Christ and choose life? Glory to God. Hallelujah. The way that seemeth right unto the man, the Bible said it is destruction. And broad is the way. But narrow is the way. And straight is the gate. And few that be that find it. Glory to God. So there's the majority of folk, hear me, saints of God, they're going down the wrong path. And God wants to use you as a light to shine in the darkness, in this dark world, in this dark time, to show them, to point them. You may be talked about, you may lie on and criticize, but get this, even on your job, people may laugh at you because you taught your Bible. Every time you see on your break, you reading your Bible, this and that, they laughing and cracking jokes. But I guarantee you this, get this, when a real problem arises, they're not going to go to those friends that they were laughing and joking with. They're going to go to the one that has the Bible, that they know has a relationship with God, that can get a prayer through. Glory to God. Hear me. And God has chosen you for that, saints of God. He wants us to be ready. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Your money can get you into heaven. Your title, your position, your status quo, hear me, can get you into heaven. Only knowing Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior and living a life that's pleasing to him. Because everyone hear me, Jesus cannot be your Savior without being your Lord. Glory to God. Savior and Lord go hand in hand. Glory to God. Because he saved you, and then you're going to follow his commands in obedience. Glory to God. Why? Because he brought you out of darkness into a marvelous light. Glory to God. He brought you out of bondage. Glory to God. Hallelujah. And so many times we're ashamed of what folk think about us, saints of God. When you know you're free, give God praise. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Don't let folks hold it over your head and try to beat you up with that. Praise God. Amen. Stand in the liberty where Christ has set you free. Let's get back to this word. It says, but that day and the hour that no man knows, not even the angels, not only my Father. That's what Jesus said. But as the days of Noah were, so also will be the coming of the Son of Man be. For as in the days before the flood, they were eating, drinking, marrying, and giving in marriage until the day Noah entered into the ark. Everyone hear me. They was living life as normal, as if God didn't exist. Glory to God. Noah preached 120 years. It's going to rain. It's going to rain. It's going to rain. Yeah, you've been saying that for the longest, Noah. We don't want to hear that. Oh, this man going crazy. He was doing something, building the ark, to put animal for safety for him and his family. Glory to God. Seven couples of the clean animals. Then one couple, one set of unclean animals. Get this. But people talked about it. People laughed at him. But get this. The day when it started raining, when God had him to go into that ark, and get this. In Genesis, the Bible said, God shut the door. Hallelujah. When God shut the door, no one can open it. Glory to God. Hallelujah. And then they saw the reality of all those things. Get this, that Noah was talking about the rain, because it never happened before. Everyone hear me. We got to stop thinking that nothing's happened when things are happening all around us. Get this, signs are meant to as an indication to show you in the direction that you headed. Glory to God. And God is showing us with the coronavirus, with the earthquakes and the tornadoes and then the hurricanes and all these different things, the wildfires in the West Coast. Get this. All these things are indicators, are signs from heaven that God is not pleased because of man's works in the earth. Glory to God. And we got to understand, saints of God, without God, we'll never make it. Jesus is our only way out. He's the way, the one and only way, the truth and the life. No man cometh unto the Father except by me. If you try to go any other way, the Bible said you come as a thief and a robber. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Goes on and says this. It says, bless the Lord. Two men would be in the field and one would be taken, another left. Two women would be grinding at the mill. One would be taken and the other left. Watch therefore, for you do not know what hour your Lord is coming. But know this, that if the master of the house had known what hour the thief would come, he would have watched and not allowed his house to be broken into. Everyone hear me. Let me give you this. What's so powerful about a thief? This what he's saying right here. That if the watchman of the house, if he had been aware, he'd been watchful, he'd been careful, he would have been waiting on, you know, on guard for the thief to come. But everyone hear me. A thief watches you. He knows your every move. He knows when you're at home. He knows when you're gone. Come on here. Glory to God. They're watching you. They know your timing. They got it synced down. Okay, they're leaving at this time. Hear me. And what God is saying, be ready at all times. Be ready at any moment. Glory to God. Glory. Don't let a moment of weakness get you. Don't let a moment of temptation drag you, because it can cost you your salvation. Glory to God. Hallelujah. And saints of God, if you fall or something, get up. Repent quickly. Repent quickly. Get back in right standing with God. Glory to God. Don't beat yourself up and stay down. That's what the devil wants you to do. Glory to God. But hear me. Don't make it a habit of sinning. Glory to God. And that's not saying sin. God don't want us to sin. But you have people practicing sin and they think they're saved and you're not. Glory to God. You can't be. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Goes on and says this. Therefore, you say, also be ready, for the Son of Man cometh. It's coming in an hour you do not expect. Saints of God, that means you don't even expect it. You don't even know what hour he coming. But hear me, be ready. I want to be ready. Will you be ready? Glory to God. Hallelujah. If you need to let things go, let it go. Glory to God. Because get this, when we get before God on the day of judgment, this life is going to be like vapor, just coming up so fast. Hear me. But eternity is without end. Hallelujah. I really deny myself right now. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Because get this, whenever we sin, get this, we open the door for the enemy, demonic spirits, demonic influence. Glory to God. That brings about bondage. Glory to God. It brings about shame, guilt, and condemnation. Glory to God. That would try to hold us down. Glory to God. But when we repent and ask God to help us, the Spirit of God is there to help us to bring deliverance. Glory to the angels of God. They're there to help us and minister us, to give us strength. Amen. To overcome anything the enemy puts in our path. Glory to God. Hallelujah. If we can see the spiritual realm, glory to God, there's so many demonic forces, even people now, witches and warlocks that's praying against us. They don't want the believers of God to rise up. But get this. Get this. Because God is for us, we are the most powerful people on earth. Not because of us, but because of Him that lives in us. Glory to God. Saints of God, get your house in order. Glory to God. All these things, time is winding down. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Don't be deceived by no man. Glory to God. When you have the Spirit of God on the inside, the Spirit of God, called the Spirit of Truth, He will reveal to you what's true, what's right. Amen. But get this. When we are contaminated with different things, compromise and sin and different things, get this. That means our discernment is polluted. That we can't rightfully discern what is real and what's not, what is true and what's not. Glory to God. And that's what brings people into deception. Glory to God. Because when the Bible said, you shall know the truth, and the truth shall set you free. God wants us, saints of God, to walk in truth. And the only way we can walk in truth is by His Spirit. Amen. Let us pray. Father, I thank You for Your word today. I pray that someone heard Your word. I pray that they would commit their lives to You, O God. Father God, I come against every weakness of the enemy that the enemy is attacking Your people with: fear, doubt, worry, stress, glory to God, anger, glory to God, even sexual sins, perversion, amen, adultery, fornication, glory to God. We come against every assignment of the enemy right now. I thank You, God, that You come in every relationship that You have put together right now. Hallelujah, that they will rise up, oh God, and put their faith in You, God. Father God, help us to stop living for ourselves and live more for You. Lord, we love You, we worship You, we adore You, and we trust You, Almighty God. Father, I thank You right now that those that are not saved, they're getting their house in order, God. They repent right now. Glory to God. Just repeat after me. Father, in Jesus' name, I accept You, Lord, as my Savior. Forgive me of my sins. I thank You for coming into my life and changing my heart right now. Fill me with Your Spirit. Lord, help me to walk upright. Glory to God. Help me to preach Your word. Help me to obey Your word in everything I do and say, God, to bring You honor and praise. Saints of God, amen. Choose this day who you serve. Amen. Be ready. Amen. Because you never know. At a moment's notice, the Lord have us out of here. Amen. If I don't see you again, I see you on the other side. God bless you and keep us at prayer. Stay prayed up, saints of God. Much love for you. Amen. Be encouraged. God bless. Amen.